Welcome back, friends. In this video tutorial, we'll be talking about the indicator microorganisms and what is the importance of this indicator organism and species to monitor the quality of the water. And because water is linked directly with our life, so we need to purify all this water. And how can we know if the water we are drinking is safe for drink or not by looking at these indicator organisms? Most of the time, these indicator organisms are microorganisms like bacteria. In fact, most of these cases we can find these things. Okay, now the presence or the absence of different indicator organisms or indicator species reflects the environmental conditions. For example, if there is extra runoff of different nutrients from the river banks, then as a result, the indicator organism that can be found in the river have a different effect on their population or the community. As a result, we can monitor this, and by looking at their change or by looking at the change in their lifestyle, we can find the type of pollution we are doing. Okay, normally the presence of a particular indicator organism signifies something very, very important, but the absence of that organisms is not that much meaningful, because absence can be done due to different causes like other than the pollution, like predation and competition and geographical barriers and so on. Okay, so but if there is the absence of multiple species or the presence of multiple species, that can suggest us a very, very important clue that something changing is going on in the environment, right? So let's move on. Now, what are the criteria for an ideal indicator organism? Now, there are several criteria. The first one is that the organism should be useful for all type of water. The organism should have a reasonably longer survival time that can give us the time to study them. Third thing is that testing method should be easy to perform on those kind of organisms, because all the things will go in vain if we cannot test or hypothesize, we cannot actually see our hypothesis acting. The fourth thing is the density of the indicator organism should have some direct relationship to the degree of pollution, right? So if suppose the density of the organisms is not proportional to the type of pollution, so we cannot correlate the presence of organisms with the degree of pollution. So for correlating this, we must have a direct proportionality with the indicator organism concentration with the type of population or the degree of population, degree of pollution. And the last one, it should be non-pathogenic. That's a very, very important point. If it is pathogenic, it will be dangerous to handle. So non-pathogenic bacteria are very, very fine and very clear to handle. If our organism contains all of these previously mentioned criteria, that would be called an ideal indicator organism. But there is no such ideal indicator organism that are present, because some of them are having some of the important characteristics, some of them are not having all this. So we need to take more than one microorganisms for our consideration to look for the indication of the water level pollution. Okay, so that's a very take home message. Now, these are the different types of indicators that we can utilize to know or to monitor the type of pollution that are going on in the water sample. Now, the indicators can be total coliforms, the type of bacteria which consists of E. coli, Enterobacter and all these things. Especially fecal coliforms are the coliforms which are directly linked with the feces of animals like humans and sometimes different warm-blooded animals. Example is E. coli in this case. Okay. Third type is a fecal streptococci. This is also related with the feces, but this is not E. coli, this is Streptococcus bacteria. These are all the biological indicators. Okay, and these are also the biological indicators. If you look at here, the bacterial phages can also be studied, because the presence of phages indicate the presence of bacteria, because phage depends on the bacterial cell for their living. Also, bacterial spores are very, very important, because bacterial spores are easy to manipulate, easy to handle, and they can be survived in these harsh environmental conditions. They cannot germinate as all the time. They can only germinate when they find their optimum environmental conditions. So they are safe to handle and all these things. So we can take these bacterial spores. and we can utilize the anaerobic bacteria like Clostridium and Bifidobacteria. As this bacteria cell do not need oxygen for their growth, we can use these bacteria separately in the anoxygenic chamber, detaching all these bacteria from the environment. So that's why these are really important. And also heterotrophic plate count can also be used, and sometimes the chemical indicators can be used. Okay, so most of these parts are made with the biological indicators, but chemical indicators can also be used for monitoring the water quality. Okay, now let's first talk about the total coliforms. Now if we look at the total coliform genera, that the total coliform begins with the family Enterobacteriaceae and includes the aerobic and the facultative anaerobic gram-negative and non-spore-forming rod-shaped bacteria that ferment lactose. So they are having the ability to ferment lactose. That's a very, very important point. And they can form the gas production with the 48 hours of incubation at 35 degrees Celsius, or we can go through the 30s or we can go through the 24 hours of incubation at 44.5 degrees Celsius, because these are the coliforms. They love to grow at the higher temperatures, not higher, actually the mesophilic temperature, which is the temperature from 30 to 45, like this. Okay, now this group includes the Escherichia coli, our very common bacteria, Enterobacter, Klebsiella and Citrobacter. Okay, now normally these coliforms are discharged in high numbers, like 29 coliforms per day per capita in the human and animal feces, but not all of them are the fecal origins. So that's why we are denoting with this total coliform and then fecal coliform. Total coliform is the whole coliform count, and some amount of them are the fecal coliforms, or they can be derived from the feces. That's why they are called the fecal coliforms. Among the fecal coliforms, there are thermotolerant coliform like the E. coli. Okay, so these are the designated parts, and among the total coliform we can have this Shigella, Salmonella, this Escherichia, Enterobacter, Klebsiella and all these things, but the fecal coliforms will be the Escherichia coli. Okay, so that's the varying part about the total coliform and the fecal coliform. Now the fecal coliforms can grow under the higher conditions, like the mesophilic conditions, like 44.5 to 50 degrees Celsius temperature is very, very good for their growth. So they can grow in slightly higher temperature than the total coliforms. Okay, because the total coliforms is also consisting of this for fecal coliforms, but especially fecal coliforms can grow in the higher temperatures, and we can find this observable growth right after the 24 hours. Okay, and this genera can be consisted of this Escherichia coli or Klebsiella pneumoniae. Both of them can be pathogenic. Klebsiella pneumoniae can cause pneumonia, and Escherichia coli, few strain of Escherichia coli, 5 or 6 strains of Escherichia coli can cause diseases. All of them are gastroenteritis or gastroenteric diseases. Okay, now this is an example of the plate where we can cultivate this coliform bacteria, and we can find the typical colony of coliform bacteria. Now this plate is called the endo-alga or EMB alga plate. So this EMB, eosin methylene blue alga, in this eosin methylene blue alga, if we plate this bacteria, this coliforms or the fecal coliforms, we can find this pink colonies, and onto the top of the pink colony we can find this green metallic sheen coming out. That can then suggest us this is the colony of fecal coliforms. Okay, and also we are having this fecal streptococcus. This group comprises of Streptococcus fecalis, Streptococcus bovis and Streptococcus equinius. Okay, and also Streptococcus avium. Because they commonly inhabited in the intestinal tract of humans and warm-blooded animals, they are used to detect the fecal contamination in water. So if we find this Streptococcus fecalis or Streptococcus bovis or equinius, we can also say that this water sample must be contaminated with the fecal waste. Okay, this can also be said. The fecal coliform to fecal streptococcus ratio or FCFS ratio has served as many years as the indicator. Now the fecal coliform, the origin of fecal coliform normally is from human waste, okay, or human feces, and the fecal streptococcus is normally from the other warm-blooded animal waste. So if the ratio of FC and FS is getting higher, for example is getting over or equivalent to 4, then we can say that the water is contaminated mostly with the human wastes. Okay, and if this ratio is getting below 0.7, for example. Okay, 0.07, we can find this pollution is caused by the animal pollution or animal waste, but not the human waste. But the higher concentration of fecal coliforms over the fecal streptococcus suggests us it is in direct contact with the human feces, which is much more dangerous for our health. Okay. And then we can also utilize this anaerobic bacteria, as we have told before. There's anaerobic bacteria like Clostridium perfringens or the Bifidobacteria can also be used. Now the Clostridium perfringens, it is an anaerobic gram-positive bacteria. So it's a positive bacteria, endospore-forming bacteria. You can see here endospores. These regions are the endospores, which you can find is when you tag them with fluorescent dye. You can see here. It's just like the bubble-like structure at the end. In all these cases, these are the endospore. Okay, they can form the endospore. This bacterium can be found in the colon and represents approximately 0.5% of the fecal microflora. It produces spores that are quite resistant to the environmental stresses and to the disinfection, since it is a member of the sulfite reducing bacterial group. So they can utilize the sulfur, and they can actually oxidize hydrogen sulfide, so they can reduce sulfate. Okay, so they can carry out their reactions like that. Okay, so this is the part. And another type of gram-negative bacteria, another type of anaerobic bacteria are the Bifidobacteria. Okay, so this bacteria is anaerobic, non-spore-forming, and also gram-positive bacteria. Okay, but the structure of the Bifidobacteria is quite distinct from other type of bacteria. We can find this irregular in shape, like this branched shape type of bacteria. More of this bacteria will look like these structures. Okay, you can find another structure here also, and this is the stained view of this, and you can find this is typically gram-positive bacteria. Okay, they live in human and animal gut, and they are very, very helpful. These microflora are very helpful or beneficial microflora of our body. Okay, so the presence of these bacteria can suggest us the presence of the fecal materials, because they can be released with feces. Okay, Bifidobacterium is the third most common genus found in the human intestinal microflora, because of them are primarily associated with these humans. They may help distinguish between human and animal contamination sources. Okay, because normally in other animal contaminations, Bifidobacteria generally is not found. Now you can utilize bacterial spores. So I've told you before, the bacterial spores or utilizing bacterial spores can have a very, very handy effect, because aerobic spores are non-pathogenic, first of all. They are ubiquitous in aquatic environments, and they occur at much higher concentration than the parasitic protozoan cysts. So they do not grow in the environmental waters, and they are easy to handle, and they are also inexpensive to study. So that's why we can utilize these bacterial spores as to measure the wastewater quality. Okay, so we can utilize this. Okay, since turbidity is not an adequate surrogate, it was suggested to use these bacillus spores. Normally, bacillus spores are used as surrogate to assess the wastewater treatment plant, because the spores are easy to manipulate, easy to handle. Their assay is simple. They do not generally pollute environmental waters. They are non-pathogenic. Okay, so that's how we can utilize them. And these are the technique like heterotrophic plate count. In this case, it represents the aerobic and facultative anaerobic bacteria that derive their carbon and energy from the organic compounds. Okay, that means the number of recovered bacteria depends on the medium composition in a period of time of incubation. For example, from 1 to 7 days of incubation at a temperature of 20 to 35 degrees Celsius. And a special media like low nutrient media R2A is used to determine bacterial numbers in the water distribution system. We can utilize this. Now this group, including gram negative bacteria belonging to the following genera, like Pseudomonas, Aeromonas, Klebsiella, Flavobacterium, Citrobacter, Serratia, Enterobacter, Acinetobacter, Proteus, and all these things. Okay, now we can find if we grow them in the low nutrient medium here for 1 to 7 days at varying the temperature from 20 to 35 degrees Celsius, we can find different types of bacterial colonies, and different bacteria are growing in different part of this plate. Okay, by looking at this, we can find the type of microorganism we are dealing with. Now we can go with the chemical indicators, not going with the biological indicators. Now the chemical indicators, they are also biological indicators. The chemical indicators in this case means if we are having the animal body, for example, we are having the animal body or cell. From this animal body, we can derive different materials or chemical materials like fecal sterols. We can derive different type of sterols and steroid or different types of nutrient sources. This can suggest us the presence of that organism in the water. Now these include the coprostenol, coprosterol and cholesterol, and also the coprostenone. Okay, a correlation between the fecal sterols and the fecal contamination have been found. Now bile acids are also potentially useful indicators for the wastewater production. So bile acids, we can keep track on to the bile acids, because the presence of bile acids can also suggest us the presence of a typical type of microorganisms. They are more resistant to degradation than the coprostenol and can help to distinguish between the human and animal contaminant sources. This is also very important to distinguish the source or the contamination from animal and human sources. Okay, now we also can go to the free chlorine residual tests, also the different level of endotoxins. Now the varying concentration of endotoxins can tell us the presence of endotoxins. Okay, now also the fluorescent lightening agents, like wastewater from human sources often contains the fluorescent lightening agents. So if we give them light, it will fluoresce. As a result, we can find or we can say that this water is contaminated with the human wastes. Okay, algae can be used as an indicator. So this, nowadays scientists are saying vigorously that algae can be used. So mark algae or take algae in large scale for knowing whether we can utilize it or not. Now what are the beneficial fact about algae to use them as indicators is that algae have very short life cycle, so we are having the rapid reproduction, which can give us result very quickly. Algae tend to be most directly affected by the physical or chemical environmental factors or physical environmental stress or changes in the environment. That's a very, very important fact, because we need to monitor the change of the environment by looking at the physiological activity and the structure of the biological molecules. The third thing is the sampling of the algae is really easy. They are inexpensive because they can grow vigorously in the water. If we give them a little bit of nutrient source, they can grow on. And there are also different standard methods that are exist to measure the amount of algae in the water. Okay, so these are for handling all these things or looking at all those important facts, we can actually take algae as an indicator in the large scale concentrations. Okay, now a different group of indicators can be used, like the process indicator, fecal indicator and index indicator. Now the process indicator is a group of organisms that demonstrate the efficiency of a process during the wastewater treatment, such as the total heterotrophic bacteria or the total coliform count. Okay, that's a very, very important part, which we can perform right after the wastewater treatment. Okay, to monitor whether the wastewater treatment is going on in the full force or not. The second time, or the fecal indicator, is a group of organisms that indicates the presence of fecal materials or fecal contaminations, such as the fecal coliforms or the presence of E. coli. The third type is the index or the model organism, which was a group of organism or group of species which indicates the pathogen presence or behavior respectively, such as E. coli as the index of Salmonella. And specific coliphages are modified to human enteric viruses. So why E. coli is called as index of the Salmonella? If E. coli is present, then we can say Salmonella must be present. Okay, so we can see by looking at the presence of E. coli, we can determine there must be presence of Salmonella in the same water sample. So one type of microorganism help us to know whether the other type of microorganisms is actually present in that water sample or not. In those cases, we call them the index or the model microorganisms. Okay, one act as the index and another work act as the model organism in that case. So here E. coli act as index and Salmonella act as the model organism. Okay, so that's it. That's a different type of technique to know different indicators, how we can see and know whether there is contaminants in the water. You can see here the algae as indicator. We have seen all these things, diatoms and algae are there. Okay, so that's it, and I hope it will help you. Thank you.